Welcome to Now in Android, episode number 37. So first up, Android 12, another developer preview was launched, DP2, as we affectionately refer to it. This one has features such as picture-in-picture improvements for the user as well as the developer. Also a cool render effect API that makes it easier to achieve effects like blur in the background and color filter effects. So definitely check that out for the graphics geeks among you, like me. There is a blog that describes some of the highlights of the overviews of the features for users as well as developers, and certainly check out the preview site for all of the details on the behavior changes, the API updates, stuff like that. There's also a couple of things that we did in the docs for the preview releases that are worth calling out. First of all, a summary. We know that dealing with some of the behavior changes can be tricky for developers, but also important. So we created a summary of what those changes are to make it easier to figure out just at a top level what's going on and how it's going to affect your app. Also, foreground services are one of the behavior changes. If your app is going to target this API and later, then there are further constraints on launching foreground services from the background. So there's documentation about what those constraints are, as well as what some of the exceptional use cases are when that actually needs to happen. So check out those docs, check out the preview, try it out on your app and send us feedback. That is why we do these preview releases, and it's pretty successful. We need to get to the stable release. So let's figure out the things that we need to fix on our way there. Mad Skills continues to roll along. The Work Manager series is ending this week. In fact, tomorrow, as I'm recording this, we will have the final episode there. So the episodes that are posted since the last Now in Android include the episode from Karen Chang on the deprecation of Firebase Job Dispatcher and GCM Network Manager. These libraries, these APIs are already deprecated, and therefore you need to migrate to using Work Manager as the way to accomplish the task that you used to use these libraries and APIs for. So there are two guides available for migrating from either one of those, and Karen walks through what you need to do with a nice code example in the IDE showing what you need to do in your application to migrate. Also, there was a community tip from Hugo Visser, shares how his team uses Work Manager for downloading in the background data from the server as well as processing that. He also talks about how they discovered an issue with one of the recent releases of Work Manager, filed issue, and hey, it got fixed. That is why we post these things out there and why we're so open about sharing what we're doing with the earlier releases to make sure that we can actually get feedback and fix those things on an ongoing basis. So if you do see an issue, please file a feature, file a bug, and we will get on that. And then finally, the final episode, as I mentioned before, is a live stream Q&A. We're going to have Ben and Karen, who hosted the series in Mad Skills, as well as Sumir Kataria and Rahul Ravikumar, who are engineers on Work Manager from the beginning, and they will be there to answer your questions. Now, by the time you're watching the video, pretty sure the video is coming out after the live stream ends. However, we will post the live stream there, and you can see what questions and answers we had during the show. Android X, ton of releases, as usual, a bunch of releases that are stable now that are essentially bug fix releases. Fragment 1.3.2, Activity 1.2.2, and Lifecycle 2.3.1. I hope you noted all of those numbers, terribly important. There were also a couple of interesting new libraries that just hit their first alpha release that I wanted to call out. First of all, sliding pane layouts 1.2.0. This one adds foldable device support. So now it can detect what's going on with the device and actually put both of those panes on the different screens of a foldable device when that's appropriate. There's also new documentation on creating a two-pane layout that was just released, so check that out. The app startup library is now being used by a couple of libraries, Work Manager 2.6.0 and Lifecycle 2.4.0. This is interesting because it is basically us eating our own dog food, but using these facilities that we've created to make it more efficient for you in your application. So I wrote a couple of articles about using startup library before, the app startup library, and why you might want to do this. There are a couple of reasons. One is that it allows you to lazily load these things, so you don't have to load everything and instantiate everything at startup time, causing potential startup delays when you don't need to. Instead, you can lazily load these things and instantiate instantiate them later when you actually need to use that facility. The other is that you can pull all of these things instead of all of the tons of libraries that you're loading, potentially having their own content provider per library and having that overhead per library. You have essentially one content provider for App Startup, and then App Startup is in charge of actually loading these other libraries as it goes. Speaking of lifecycle 2.4.0, this version also adds APIs in the artifact that's lifecycle runtime KTX for collecting a Kotlin coroutines flow from your UI. This is timely because Manuel Vivo just posted a blog, which I was going to refer to later, that shows a safer way to collect this flow from the UI and then how to interact between this flow and your UI to do it right. Speaking of articles, so first of all, there's the one from Manuel, so certainly check that out. Also, there's an article from Dan Galpin on Oboe. So we talked about Oboe on one of the A2B podcasts a year or so ago with the engineers that have been working on it. This is a native library that makes it easier to achieve high performance and low latency audio. This library is now integrated into the Games SDK, and Dan Galpin's article on the Android Developer blog goes into the details on that. Also, there's an article from Nicole Borelli on pending intents and when and how you might want to actually use those properly. This is important because there is a change for apps that are going to be targeting Android 12. If you're using pending intent, then you need to declare the mutability of those pending intents. So it's good to actually understand mutability and how to use them properly. This article would be a good place to start figuring that out. On the training front, we had a new unit come out for the ongoing course, Android Basics in Kotlin. So this is a course for people that are going to learn programming as well as programming in Android, as well as programming in Kotlin, all at the same time in this course. We have 3 units out there, and now we have 4. So unit 4 just came out. This is specifically about doing internet, networking, communication stuff. So in particular, along the way, people that tune into the course are going to be learning how to use Kotlin coroutines, more and more important, but also they're going to learn how to use retrofit and coil for loading data over the network. So common open source libraries out there that people are using for doing network transaction stuff and coil. Again, we did a podcast episode with the coil author about dealing with images and dealing with network images, bring them down over the network and loading them into your application. So check out that unit to learn more about all of those libraries and coroutines as well. And then finally, speaking of podcast, there was a major change internally for the podcast, which shouldn't affect anybody that's listening to it already, which is we moved the site. So if you typically go to the site that we have on Blogger for checking out the show notes, you will now go to a new site, which is on Libsyn. It's adbackstage.libsyn.com. That will have the show notes and the lovely pictures that we take from our screen grabs when we have guests and we remember to take the picture. We also put it on a new feed, but again, you shouldn't need to change anything. If you are subscribed to the current feed, we just delegate to the new feed and hopefully it just works magically. You shouldn't have to resubscribe. In the meantime, we also had a new episode. Romain and I talked to Chris Lacey, who's a longtime Android independent app developer who has tons of apps out there. We talked about some of those apps and how he developed them and how he used the Android framework platform and library APIs to develop those and things that he's learned about Android along the way. So super interesting. It's also a good example of why, like, we usually record the podcast in a studio, and then the studios went away last March, and we're doing all this remote recording. A bit more of a hassle, and the audio quality certainly took a hit because everybody's recording in their own homes. On the other hand, we get to call people in Australia and do a podcast with them. So it does open the door up to having lots of different topics and lots of different people, so we're taking advantage of that along the way. As usual, all of the links to everything that I talked about are in the article. So check out the article for Now in Android number 37 on Medium. And if you like the video, go ahead and like and share and subscribe to the Android Developers channel on YouTube. Thanks.